A scaphoid fracture is a break of a bone in the wrist called the scaphoid. The scaphoid is shaped like a cashew nut and it's right at the base of the thumb.
The scaphoid is a very important bone as it acts as a link between the two rows of bones present there. And if it's broken and not healed, it can lead to arthritis and degenerative changes in the wrist. People oftentimes mistake it for a sprain. So if there's pain at the base of the wrist on the side of the thumb after an injury, it really should be evaluated. The most common way for someone to suffer a scaphoid fracture is from a fall in an outstretched hand. They fall, they put their hand out to break their fall, they fall with enough force that it breaks that small bone. So non-surgical options for a scaphoid fracture are a cast, but it has to be a specific type of scaphoid fracture.
The decision for surgery depends on a couple things. One is how well aligned that scaphoid break is, and the second is how old that scaphoid break is, because there are difficulties with that scaphoid bone healing if that break's been around too long.
Scaphoid fracture surgery generally is an outpatient surgery. It depends on how the fracture is, what the location of the fracture is, and how fresh the fracture is, how long the procedure will take. For a fracture that's at the base and it requires surgery because of the location of the fracture, but the fracture isn't displaced, we just need to put a screw into the bone and that won't take very long. If the fracture is old and has collapsed, formed a cyst, that'll need to be reconstructed, brought out to length, require a bone graft, and that can be a much longer surgery. Either way, it can be done with regional anesthesia so the patient doesn't have to go completely to sleep unless it needs a bone graft from the area about the hip, and then the patient would have general anesthesia. Scaphoids take a long time to heal, so even after surgery, there may be a need for immobilization for several weeks. Early recovery, as far as being able to move your fingers, is almost immediate, but the healing of the fracture may take 6, 8 weeks or longer.
After non-operative treatment with a cast or after surgical treatment, it's hoped that the patient's able to return to all of their normal activities without discomfort, without a sensation of stiffness. But we realize that scar forms, and so a patient's really reach a new normal. So there may be a little bit of wrist stiffness, but hopefully no pain and hopefully no issues with returning to everything they like to do.